So, yeah. Hold your horses. If oh, we already destroyed it, so we have to do this before we destroy it. So, if mobs attribute IDX dot name, totally care about so I want to look at the fifth character in a string. So, I don't know, string mid. Middle character. It's kind of nice. Nice, this is a little more helpful. So, what would I do if I was looking for another useful thing? I would look for, like, what get component. And I would come up with, like, this type of. Huge list of stuff. And string wouldn't be on here. So yeah, what am I looking for then? Maybe I just shouldn't bother. Maybe I should just keep track of this separately. Yeah. Don't care. Mobs. Hooray. Mobs take equals new new int 3. Nope. Max mobs. Yeah. Save that. Mobs created down at the bottom, and then we increment their mobs type pop. We can also, I've already indented. We can also mobs type what MCT. Equals MPF. Why are you indenting like that? Why? What else was I doing? Oh yeah. At the time of destruction. Which is here. Oh right, okay, so yeah, screw that. Minus minus pop, minus minus mob types up mobs type tribute idx. Alright, strings. I feel like strings should at least be as malleable as they are in Microsoft Excel. If a scripting language can't handle strings as well as Microsoft Excel can handle strings, I mean, I might as well just be programming in Microsoft Excel. Like that dude who made an entire game engine in Microsoft Excel. What am I looking for? Oh yeah, population statistics. Alright, so yeah, that that was more like what I was expecting, I guess? No, I guess I can't really tell yet, right? I should have to see more stuff happen before I can tell for sure. Yeah, like, hypothetically, the end of hot dogs. Hot dog bites. Hot dog bites. Sorry, so no hot dog bites. Still only 18. Weird. Right? Am I crazy? I feel like it should have been like super low. Like, I don't know. Not that high. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter, but. I mean, I guess there are other things that I should be spending my time on. Yeah, right, because, like, there are literally only, like, 3 hours and 45 minutes left at this point, so the only things I should be working on at this point should be really important. I'm like, I don't know. I feel like this kind of is. I could just fundamentally change how I choose those ratios. Yeah. Well, here's an idea. I'll just start by chopping them a little bit. And then, I like Min as my new best friend. I just like Min. So, yeah. You are now much simpler. You're just that divided by that. That's all. Is that divided by that? What are you complaining about? Oh, I got rid of the semicolons. Alright, so how about them apples? Yeah, that's accurate. Okay, so right, I'll just say, minimum, my new favorite thing, mathf dot minimum, oops, so it's either that or 0.1f, whichevs. Spaces want to develop. You know I don't like them. You literally know I don't like them. I literally went into the settings and told you that I do not like them. What? No. The minimum is 0.1. You're not allowed to be 0.07. The minimum is literally 0.1. The minimum is literally 0.1f. You cheater. It's like you're not even trying sometimes, honestly. Cool. Yeah, the minima is 0.1. 0.08 is less than 0.1. Oh, right. I always do that. I declare a minimum and then use minimum when I actually mean to declare a minimum and choose maximum. Yep. Maximum is my new best friend. Maxima and minima. I honestly can't tell if anyone's watching right now. If anyone is, feel free to let me know why. Because, like, I don't know. If you, maybe just you just drew the, like, syntax errors. Because you do. You come to the right place. Cool. So yeah, let's play through, I guess. This new improved version of the game. Let's see how it goes. Yeah, so right, I said after, like, if this pans out, I said I was gonna put like some interactivity into the beach scene, into the island scene, and then yeah, sorry. That's gonna take a little bit of math, but it'll probably be doable, I guess. I don't know. We'll find out. Yeah, sorry. Oh yeah, I should take out those other things. Three is fine. No, sorry. What would you sacrifice? You, sorry. What would you sacrifice? You, sorry. I guess I can do that. So what's the point of having that? Ugh. Alright. Alright, this is better. I like this a lot better. Oh god. Ah, those costs. Alright, I guess. I don't know. I feel like it starts off a little too slow at first, and then. Sorry, okay, I should. I start with a higher cost scale. Like a base cost scale, I guess. Okay, so. Yeah, right, so yeah, no. I don't have many options right here. Yeah, because like the number of dudes is really, or like the, like I ran out of money really fast, and then the number of gaios stayed relatively high. So now I'm just like chopping through dudes. So maybe. Oh, I have an idea. I'll only. Yeah, I'll only jack up the cost if. No, you know what? I mean, population has enough of an impact on. Sacrificing dudes has enough of an impact on. Productivity based on the population that I don't think we actually even need to change the mob cost scale in the event of the event of which sacrifice. Although I do want sacrifice to be the worst of the two options by a significant margin. So I don't know. Okay. Yeah, I can probably tone down the cost scale because I actually want sacrificing coins to be an option, really. Yeah, I can keep productivity under control, and then reduce the cost scale a little bit. Yikes. Yeah, I'm gonna raise the minimum cost of a dude. Not the raw cost, the tribute cost. That's good. By the time I got to the 99, it's like literally laughable. Yeah, I felt like I had to make too many sacrifices. So I'm gonna scale down productivity slightly. Or wait, do I only have productivity affected by morale? Maybe if I just affect reproductivity by morale, that'll do the trick. Yeah, no, I don't have morale going on here, so don't have to increase it because it felt okay. And I will have to play through at least a few more times I'll just play again. Because I remember the other thing I was gonna do. I was gonna increase the base tribute cost, the minimum tribute cost. Which is here. So let's say 0.8. I just want to make sure there's not a strategy to sacrifice heavy early. So maybe actually I should split the POW secondary into two values and just tone down the cost instead of eliminating it entirely. Because I don't necessarily want to punish the payment strategy. So POW secondary it started as 0.4, where am I going? Here. Okay, it started as 0.4 for both, but I think actually POW secondary So I'll say POW SCND POW secondary mob cost SCND POW. And then I'll refactor this one to tribute PD SCND POW. And so then there's the tribute cost secondary POW. And so then we'll also have public flow of cost CND POW equals, I'm thinking 0.2F. Just because of how much of an effect the price increases have. Really, you start with less resources in that regard, so you can run out a lot faster, so I guess that'll be how that's balanced separately. So, see how that works. Did I take out those prints? I don't think I did. I did not. Save. Alright. Wow. We've been up for 8.5 hours. All those viewers who've been watching for a solid 8.5 hours, you are the best viewers. You're the super best. So, alright, that barely had an impact. So yeah, like I said, I'm just checking out sacrifice strategy, which probably sucks. It's probably a bad strategy. I hope. I mean, it's hard to say. Was, yeah, wow, we lost, I think, a lot faster this time. Yeah, and I think morale really helps. Morale, quote unquote. Yeah, I think that was a new record for bringing it all crashing down. And just for comparison, now I'll make decisions. Like that seems cost effective. That seems fine. It's like already, I think we're doing better. He's like, yeah, I might need to sacrifice that, but I mean, like, I'm pretty sure, like, it's impossible for this group to fail to produce as much as the previous one did. Maybe I have to make some cuts there. Sacrifice in red, or like emphasize it somehow. What will you sacrifice? Big prim. Which I could do pretty easily, I could just make it a different GUI text thing with its own font size and stuff. Probably do that. Because I don't think I'm actually going to write anything for this game either. Again, playing to my strengths, I guess. Okay, the volcano dimension should be what we sacrifice. Sorry. Okay. No, sorry. Yeah, I'll do that. Can't. Literally can't. Maybe this death march that happens, tends to happen, maybe that'll drive people to like rebel when they see they're getting gated into what seems like a horrible and impossible outcome. That they can see that this cost is rising as more steadily than their income, so then what do we do for interactivity? Kind of wanna like let you click the ground and make, I don't know, something appear on the ground there. But kind of like the how the coins or the I don't know why I've taken to calling the cassettes or the cartridges coins at this point, but I have started calling the coins hot dog pieces, so maybe that's not completely confusing. Yeah, maybe just maybe like balloons. I don't know. I guess it has to be a distinct shape, so if it's too spherical, that'd be weird. If it's too coin shaped, that'd be weird. If it's too octahedral, that'd be weird. I could just make little stars, I guess. Maybe the stars just kind of like float about for a while and then just disappear. Maybe they're all colors. How would I want to handle the volcano though? Maybe you can only make stars from a mob. Yeah, maybe you have to click near a mob to make stars. Maybe if you make enough stars, you get a rainbow or something. I don't know. Let's make a star then, I guess. What is this? Oh, yeah, I remember. So, I don't know, close or like new. Don't save. 256 by 256. Because that's the size the cool kids make their textures. Cool kids don't have such hyperactive mouse. Alright, so save this as stars, I guess. Or star. Dot paint. Should be multiple stars on a single sheet. Nah, but I will put multiple stars in a single entity so that we don't have to regulate. Or there won't be quite as many star entities floating around. We'll have more stars per star entity. And so, yeah, so stars, huh? Oh, I guess I could just do the built-in MS Paint star, I guess. I don't know, it's not bad. I'll just make my own though. Straight line tool. Straight line tool. Why do you not do things? Oh, okay. That's interesting. I feel like that's the second time I pressed you, actually, though. 256. 27. 28. 128. Is there a 0 pixel? Or does it start at 1? There's a 0 pixel. Just zoom in more. Yeah, it's certainly a 0 pixel. 0 and 128, 127, I guess. I guess I kind of want the They don't have to be super pointed. I was gonna say I want the edges to be pointed, but they don't have to be super pointed. I can always like sculpt them a little bit. 128, 0, 216. Was it 90? Yeah, 90. Is that? No, that's not right. That's better. But then on this side, it's a star. Yay, I made it all by myself. I guess. Oh, yeah, I was gonna make it different color, I guess. How do I do that? I guess I would do that by converting this to be black on the outside, white on the inside, and then saving it, and then setting it. Oh, you can stop doing stuff. Alpha from grayscale, alpha is transparent. Apply. Yeah, there we go. And so then let's make a create a material for star map. Yeah, I guess unlike the coins, I think we're gonna have like a fixed number of them because we'll make it so that you can only. No, we'll make it so that every. Yeah, there'll be like a rotating index, and so every time you make one, it'll just use the next index, and it'll loop back around from the maximum number back to zero. And so if you keep clicking, you'll start destroying your old ones, which is fine, I guess. And then there'll be enough just that it's fun. So if you click at a reasonable pace, you don't accidentally destroy your old ones very much. All right, so star mat. Let's put the star texture on star mat. And then let's make a quad. Cloud. Whoa. You looked really big for a second there, cloud. I guess let's put you at the origin. No, go away. And then let's rotate you towards the camera. Yep, towards the camera. No, this way. Because you just disappeared like that. So let's put the star mat on, yeah. You're still going to be mostly invisible. Let's call you star. Let's move you someplace actually that we can see you. where are you? Wait. Oh. Oh, right, because we haven't used a transparent material. There we go. So let's make a empty game object stars. And then put star in stars. Oh, actually, first let's zero out stars. Zero, zero, zero. And then put star in stars. And then put more star in stars in stars. Yeah, there we go. So what then? I guess the stars should have a script so that they do cute things. So let's give them scripts. Give them a script. Give them each a script. Give a script to each of them. Make script and give that script to each of them. Star. So star. What's star going to do? It is going to on start render dot material dot color equals new color random dot value random dot value random dot value and let's also position, I guess. Transform form. Transform. Okay. Dot position equals transform dot position equals new vector 3 random dot value random dot value 0 just for a change of pace. Alright, so how about that? I guess I can make them rotate too. I can make them like rapidly rotate so that it looks like they were kind of like twinkling. Although, then I'd have to. I don't know. Or I could just make them actually twinkle by like randomly turning on and off. Or not randomly, but like at intervals turning on and off. I guess that's cool. I don't know. Public float twinkle down. equals 0.05 f. So then void fixed update if so yeah float error yeah actually so it would be float twinkle time equals 0 and this will actually be twinkle dir. So if twinkle twinkle time is less than time dot fixed time um render.enabled equals not render.enabled. So whatever it is, it toggles between the two. And then twinkle time equals time plus twinkle dir. Yay. Now we have little twinkling stars of all colors. And the reason you put in like a little script like on the big entity to act kind of like the cartridges and like float up, slip gradually upwards, not rotate, but just float gradually upwards. So yeah. Now let's give all of these stars. There's star. Oh, actually, you know what? So this is a star prefab, and so now that we have the star prefab, let's put a bunch of the star prefab into stars, three of them to be specific. Oh, right, I just remembered something. We don't actually want transform position to be that, we want transform local position to be that. That way they'll stay with their parent, but they'll just like move, like shift, you know, they'll offset themselves by a slight amount. So, cool. Are there, oh, they're like weird dots on the edges there, huh? Alright, so we need to change the material a little bit to have slightly smaller tiling, so like 0.9, I guess. How's that help? 0.9? Nope. Did you just... What did you do? Okay, so... Yeah, no. Oh, okay, so 1.1? No? 1.1? No. What? Alright, so, alright, that tiling is clearly not correct. Offset, wait a second. Oh, alright, you jerk. With your little white dots around the edges. Don't tile, hello. How's that sound? Maybe on the star image I can change something. Oh, wrap mode, yeah, nope. No wraps. None of the wrapping. Alright, there we go. Way better. Alright, so, and then, what? Yes, if I. Thank you. And then stars is also a prefab. And it also needs a script. New script. And this will be stars. The script. Not at all confusing. And stars will, as mentioned, it will be somewhat reminiscent of currency in that transform position equals something like this. Whoops. And then also, what? Divide by 2. You know what? I don't think they can be elastic like the cartridges. Like the cartridges like spring up really fast. I think these guys are just gonna float up gently, like bubbles kind of. So transform position equals transform equals new vector 3 transform, transform dot position dot x transform. Dot position transform dot position dot y plus fixed. I should put this in fixed update. Am I using fixed update for currency? Yeah. Void fixed update. Plus fixed. Plus time dot fixed delta time. Transform dot position. Excuse me. Transform. No, you're weird, and stop. Dot position. I don't care what you think, because you're weird, and stop. Lowercase two. Jerk. so, yeah, now they'll just float gently upwards. Let's see how that goes, I guess. I don't know. Oh yeah, also start float bday equals float bday start bday equals time dot fixed time. If bday float lifetime lifespan, if bday plus lifespan this is the saddest is less than time dot fixed time, destroy this dot game object. Womp womp. Yeah. So, right, this is the stars prefab, and we don't need it here anymore. Actually, though, what? Send your own stars? You said there was something wrong here? Did not say that. Of parsing error. Oh, I never ended fixed update. Yay. Okay. Cool. Oh, you weirdo. Oh, whoops, yeah. Thank you. Float lifespan equals I don't know. I'll make this public. Float lifespan equals 3 seconds, I guess. Better? Yeah, good. Let's add a prefab. Let's know about the prefab for stars. Public game object stars prefab. So yeah, in another project I had a quick way of finding the where you click on the ground. It was here, and it was in play.cs. What was it? It was like it was down at the bottom. Yep. Scan range. Oh, here we are. Ray ground intersection. Let's just take all of this, shall we? Full steps equals, yeah, this is it. Using it for UI. So what? So what? I guess we could scale this by morale. So, oh yeah, so when I say scale by morale, so hypothetically, I guess like we could make it so that the stars were more successful the higher your morale. So like with perfect morale, like you get stars and they're all good and stuff, and then I don't know if I really want to have the color of the stars affected by morale. I mean, you could make it more drab, more or less drab. I'm just gonna make them appear for starters. So, yeah. Oh, mob diameter. Do I actually have that variable, or are you just like, I don't know. Was weird. Do I actually have? Oh no, I probably do have a variable for mob diameter. Right, because yeah, I'm using the other system from here. So so on GUI, if get mouse button down. Yeah, let's put it in here. So if current. Scene. I'm just gonna do this as an else. Else. If current scene is equals 2. Then what? Yeah, so. Instantiate stars prefab ray ground intersection input dot mouse How do I use right around intersections? open play playground. Oh, camera dot main dot screen point array input mouse position. All right. Identity or quaternion.identity. Hey, alright. So that should all just work perfectly. And then the project should all of a sudden be magically AAA forever. I bet. Alright, so. Yes, perfect. Nothing apparently happens. Or else, I don't know. Well, no, I think we probably noticed if something was happening because we'd be instantiating a prefab. So let's see what the deal is. Wait, were we getting any like errors? No, not even any errors. Alright, whatever. Print stars. Right, which is a string or a quote. Save that, ship it. We're not even printing stars. Alright, I don't know. Maybe that else is like weirding things up or something. Alright, save. Oh, current scene equals 2? No, current scene equals 0. Wah. Alright, so we probably don't need that print. At least I hope we don't. Else. Alright, stars. Stars. Why you know stars? It's like creating itself and just destroying itself instantaneously. I mean, yeah, it's definitely creating stars. That's cool. Yeah, it's totally working. They're just like all destroying themselves instantaneously. Why? Stars prefab has a lifespan of 0. Yeah, that would explain it. Oh, I guess, yeah. I should also, for star, I should randomize the twinkle time at start. Twinkle time equals random dot value times twinkle there. Here we go. Yeah. Look at all those twinkling stars. Perfect. Perfection. So good. So good. This is just like instantaneously amazing. I can't get over how good this is. It's all just so good. yep. Super good. Alright, for one thing, they're going in bucket. Game object. STRS equals. Da-da-da-da-da. As game object. STRS dot No, bucket is a transform. Yep. Why are there stars there to start with? Oh, because they left one in there. Alright. Yay, stars. Alright, so I'm pretty sure they're twinkling a little too fast. Just a skosh too fast. So let's say twinkle time is like 0.1. Still high. Or still low. 0.2. No, maybe that's not what. Maybe that's not the weird part. What if it was like a lot? What if it was like twinkle time like 1? You're not even paying attention, are you? Because for whatever reason, these stars, twinkle times, are not changing. Why? Why? You're the prefab. It means you like that for a reason. Alright, so anyway, 0.05. No, go away. So fine, your twinkle times will be 0.1. Is that. Say. Oh, I do know one thing to say is cooldown. Public or not public. Float button time or click time. 0 float click CD equals 0.1 F and on GUI current scene equals 1 and click time is less than time that fixed time click time equals time dot fixed time plus click CD. Because for whatever reason, clicks get processed twice in Unity. Don't know why, but yeah, we're making excessively many stars. I guess maybe the individual stars should have like sway. I mean, there's something really like fundamentally wrong with these stars. Just like really fundamentally wrong, but I'm not gonna bother thinking about that too much right now. Let's try punching down the scale a little bit. See how that goes. See how that helps. Alright, well, that's a little bit better. They look slightly less bad. Like that. Although, the twinkle. Yeah, definitely gotta fix the twinkle too. So let's say, what if stars no star fixed update so yeah, what if yeah, so for twinkle time, Twinkle time equals render dot enabled question mark. If render is enabled, then it'll twinkle out for twinkle duration. If render is not enabled, it will twinkle out for 4 times the duration. Or it'll twinkle in for 4 times the duration. So yeah, now the twinkle is not just a constant flicker, it's just like a slightly more twinkly twinkle, hopefully. And yet it's all the same. Oh, I know. Twinkler times 4. Get it. Where they're all twinkling at the same time. They should be choosing random values. Or are they all choosing the same random value? Why is it like... Yeah, why are they... Seems like they're all choosing the same random value, which is weird. Alright, fine. Fix time plus twinkleder times 4 times 2 plus random dot value times 2. Alright, this one sounds 3. Alright, how about that? Stop twinkling together, you cowards. Almost helps. Alright, so what if twinkle duration is times 2 and this is just random value? Okay, so this is also twinkle dir plus random value, I guess. Actually, no, there's no point in having it as a plus there. So, times, yeah. Yeah, times 4. Sure. Why? So. Oh, plus random value. Yeah, no, that's not gonna work. Yeah, right. So twinkle dir times 2 plus twinkle dir times 2 plus random value. Yeah. Yeah, right, okay. That makes more sense now. Maybe twinkling is not the right effect. Honestly, I have no clue. Maybe this is fine. Maybe this is perfect. I should just ship it. enough fun with it, I suppose. It is a shippable. We could just have the success values tied to morale. Oh, I guess I don't have to have the stars decide their own color. I could have, oh yeah, so right, Twinkledur times, 7 plus random value times 4. Yeah, the stars don't necessarily have to choose their own colors. I could, alright, less that, and actually just more Twinkledur in general. 3 and 1.5, I guess. And then Twinkledur, blah blah bloop bleep bloop bloop bleep bloop. Twinkledur, blah blah bloop bleep bloop bloop bloop. Yeah, this is pretty. I think this is this Twinkle feature is. Or this, these stars are pretty much exactly what the project needed at this point. Alright, I still have to stop them from, like, freaking out at the start. Why are you freaking out? How about times, like, 8? Right? Wait. Yeah. Times was fixed. Okay, yeah. Okay. I don't know. Maybe fixed time at start is weird. Maybe that's what it doesn't like. Twinkle time. Twinkle time, twinkle there, twinkle there, twinkle there. How about 0.5? This 0.5 is twinkle there. You always just like disappear immediately. Why are you so weird? Maybe that's why. So okay, twinkle time equals like 900. Oh, right. Nope, I'm just weird. Smart, bad. What's the opposite of smart? Right. I'm not adding in fixed time. Time dot. Alright. Ship it. This game is 100% done. Alright, now smaller twinkle time. 0.2. Twinkle time. Alright, and I can make that less now. Because it doesn't have to be as exorbitant. Yeah, whatever. Yay, twinkle time! Alright, so we should add some variability to how these stars float around. Okay, specifically, we should add in two. star. Yeah. Shed into star. That. What do we want the period of oscillation to be? I'm gonna add a sine wave to the x value of star, like each individual star. So float osc period equals, I want it to be very floaty, so let's say 5. And then, so actually, position is not, the x position is not random value, it's math f dot sine time dot fixed time times osc per. I'll tune that. And so then let's do this fixed update as well, except it's not random anymore. It's a transform dot local position dot y. Sure. And then let's see how that goes. Oh, I didn't make ask per public. Cause I don't know if it's in degrees or radians or what. It's pretty fast. Also, I forgot to add in a random element to it. Yeah, so that was too fast. Let's bump the period up. Well, I'll have to do it. It's public now, so I'll have to do it outwards. So then also flow osc offset on start. Wait, on start flow, no, osc offset equals random dot value times osc per, and then this is also plus osc offset. Yeah. So that way they won't all oscillate together. They'll oscillate separately. Save that. Probably double the oscillation period, right? Because those were oscillating pretty fast. Oh. Right, that's how that works. I could halve the oscillation. And by oscillation period, I actually mean at this point. Oscillation frequency. Yeah, make it like, I don't know, like 2 maybe. Yeah, still gives an overall effect of a bit too much. So that's also yeah. Let's also choose an x value, like a base x. So yeah, let's choose two more things. Float osc scale, also known as amplitude, Float x offset. Okay, so now osc scale equals 0.5 plus 0.5, or these are floats, times random dot value, and then also x offset equals random dot value, random dot value times 0.5f. So actually, the x value equals x off set plus osc scale times all that. And just like before that. So now let's see how that works. Yay, that's a little bit better. I still have kind of an odd sense of togetherness, but I guess they don't all need to oscillate like that. Wait, are there any going against the grain? No, they're pretty much all swimming together. Like, there are none going directly opposite each other. Is that... No, maybe there are... I don't get it. I don't know, maybe that's fine. But yeah, we can tone down the osc scale too. So 0.2, let's say, is the minimum, and then 0.8 is the variation. Reduce the twinkle duration. Just reduce the twinkle duration. No, yeah, let's reduce the twinkle duration and bump up the... Oh, I know. Yeah, we don't need the stars to choose their own color. Because we can... just unplugging my... I unplugged the power because it's just been at 100% for a while, but then I forgot that that would cause the screen to dim, which was actually my primary light source, so hopefully that's a little bit better. Okay, so, right, yeah, so the stars don't paint themselves anymore. Now, when we make the stars for int I equals 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, creeping up on 10 o'clock. And I started streaming this afternoon, so this has been a pretty good stream. I kind of feel like tweeting, like brag tweeting that I've been streaming for nearly 10 hours. Kinda. Kinda, why not? I might have an entire other thing of tomato juice. I drank an entire thing of tomato juice, and I think I'm gonna have another entire thing of tomato juice. I feel like since I'm pretty close to the 10-hour mark, I don't have to like pretend to be like competent or like I don't know. I can stop being nervous about how I come off and like whether I'm being like entertaining or interesting. Because now I'm clearly not going for quality. I'm clearly going for quantity at this point. So, thanks for staying tuned. I appreciate it. Yeah, I think I'm gonna brag tweet, if you don't mind. So yeah, live stream hour 10. I added twinkly colored stars when you click. Where you click, I guess. Wherever you click. Oh, maybe I should make the little duders jump towards the stars. Maybe that would be fun interactivity. Although at that point, I'd want to take like, oh man, I'd be taking so much from here because I have a system. I have like a targeting system where, I don't know, maybe. Maybe. That'd be fun, right? Yeah, sorry. I was like, I should. No, I don't have an excuse. I was just like literally lost in thought. But it's creeping up on hour 10, so like I said, I'm taking a few liberties with this one. All right. No, if I get too bad, I'll just cut it off because like there's really no point in streaming. If I can't even keep it together, so. All right, so yeah. Had twinkly colorful stars wherever you click. Alright, so. Yeah. I made it so twinkly colorful stars. Live stream hour 10. I made it so twinkly colorful stars appear wherever you click. Yay. Cool. Right, I'm back. I'm paying attention again. I'm a real person, I swear. We're gonna color the stars based on prefabs? Or the spontaneous colors, I guess. Is that better? Yeah, I don't know. We'll see if it's better or worse or whatnot. Okay. So stars dot get child. Oh wait, if you get the child, the transform. It's not actually the game object. I wonder if we do get child. Wait. Oh, stars transform dot get child I dot game object. Game object, yeah, alright. And we want to get the game object. Actually, I want to get the game object to get the renderer, to get the material, to get the color. That works fine, right? Sure, why not? Spont colors random dot value times spont colors dot length times 0.999999f. That could work. Maybe. Let's find out. What? Oh, right, yeah. Math to int floor. Math f to int. Floor to int. Math f dot floor to int. And then all that goodness. Save that. Alright. Now let's see if it worked. Should be. Nope. Did not work. They're probably showing up, but they're. Are they even showing up? Well, we're not getting, like, errors, so. Oh. I don't know what's happening. What if I. Let the star continue to choose its own color and then slam another color on top of it? Would that be better? No, it's just keeping its old color. And like the swing together thing, I don't know if I'm super fond of that. So let's fix that. I don't know. Ring value times os frequency times let's look up math f dot sign. Let's learn a little more about math f dot sign. Unity script C sharp math f dot sign. Turns the angle f in radians. Math f dot pi? Is that a thing? Oh, pi. Yeah, there it is. Yay. All right. So. So the offset. Yeah, let's offset it by pi. Maybe that'll be better. I think that's better. Okay. Although maybe I should just tone down this way altogether. Because it gets a little over dramatic. So the oscillating scale, let's say so it can be low as like 0.05. And then it only varies by like 4 or so. Maybe it can vary by as much as like 0.6, but also let's raise it to the power of dos so that it doesn't go that high very often. Because if you raise to the power things that are less than 1, they get smaller. Colorful stars, colorful stars. Yay! Alright, kinda like how that looks. And those are still just random colors though. They're not the prefabs that I was trying to put on top of them. So, I don't know. Don't know how I feel about that. Well, for one thing, I should actually go. Is less than strs dot child count transform dot child count. Let's look at transform dot get child. And then let's also look at how transforms. Game objects. Alright, well, I mean that seems fine. Seems like sensible enough, I suppose. I'd almost expect it to work, for example. But, I don't know. Maybe the tons of colors are fine. Oh, but yeah, I was gonna use it to scale based on. So, alright, maybe. Maybe I just made, like, some other funny difference. So, maybe. Maybe just do just times equals morale. Wait, what would that do? It'd make them like black, right? I don't know if I necessarily want to do that. I kind of want to make them go to grayscale. So, do colors. Can you affect color saturation? Color sat no grayscale. That sounds convenient. I wonder if it does what I would like it to. Color dot grayscale. What does that do? The grayscale value of the color? What? How convenient. Alright, oops, no, I didn't mean to do that, and I accidentally opened another program. Don't be opened. Okay, so yeah, that's pretty cool. alright, so instead of that, let's do, yeah, let's do, stars transform. So, what then? This equals, Material color equals this whole thing. Times pop plus this whole thing, so plus this whole thing dot grayscale. Actually, for starters, let's just do something really simple. Let's just do it equals itself dot grayscale to see if anything here is even working remotely. Alright, so now we should have a bunch of grayscale stars, I hope. What? Float. What's a float? Grayscale's a float? Wait. Where's a float? Oh, yeah, derp. Okay, so. Alright. So. Alright. Alright. Also saying alright. Also saying sorry. Float gers equals such and such dot grayscale. And this equals new color gers gers gers. Let's see if that works. So yeah, now hypothetically all the stars should be grayscale. Nope. It's just the regular colors. Just the same colors they usually are. Sweet. Alright, so to what extent should I continue to bother? Yeah, that doesn't. It just seems like a cursor effect. It doesn't actually seem like interactivity. Also, still sprinkling way too much stars. So let's pump you up to like 8, and then pump you up to like 6 and 4. Save that. Stars are like a serious feature. So serious. Such a feature. So, right, stars. Stars. Why? Why stars? Why these little stars? So, I could put together. I could make the, I could make it so that the little duders gravitate towards the stars. I can make it so that, well, let's Let's see if we can't get the stars to make a little, to, I don't know, do something. With regard to the color, because I don't know, it just doesn't make sense to me that that this is doing literally nothing. So maybe we can figure out where something's going on. So print Gris. Let's see if we're even getting Gris. Is it one? Why is Gris always one? I mean, it's printing three times, but like the grayscale value of those should not be one. Not for all of them. You're supposed to be a float. Understand. Besides, if this were working, it would. If Gris was one, and this is working, it would make them all white. So let's just see how far down this chain of like stuff actually works. So yeah. Liar. You liar. Why would you lie like that? Why? Why? I mean, you clearly... maybe because it's just not even giving them a chance to start. I guess. But that doesn't explain why setting them to random colors over here didn't work. Because, like... So now hypothetically, they should all be solid white. Yeah, so there's just solid white stars there. Okay, and now... Now... It should just be like before, they should all just be random colors. Oh! Which is like before, they are just random colors. Alright, so yeah, maybe the only thing I screwed up was the thing about how they were selecting a color or something. I don't know, whatever. I'm not gonna look a gift horse in the mouth. So right, so now what? So so I guess I can just do the grayscale thing, because why not? So for one thing... No, I guess that's fine. Okay, wait, color, yeah, we'll make the color first, and then we'll slap it on. Okay, so, color... equals the whole random dot value thing. Times pop plus grayscale new color stirk dot grayscale three times times minus pop our lost soldiers. All divided by all divided by MCT. So with the zero population, everything should be completely grayscale. But with 100% population, everything should be completely chromatic. If this works. STR, oops, underscore C. Yay, now please work. Pleasey please. Pleasey pleasey please. Alright, colorful. Super colorful. So far so good. Let's put the tribute time, tribute period way down. So it looks pretty colorful to me. Oops. Yeah, I'm not seeing the effects of the grayscale yet, but maybe it's just gonna take a little while to become especially noticeable. I should probably be printing the colors of the... Oh, okay. Actually, maybe they're getting grayscale. We're getting close too, so... Yeah, those look super grayscale, in my opinion. In my professional opinion. Those stars look super grayscale. Lame. Yeah. Should probably make them... Nah. Yeah, I guess I could make them oscillate less based on their... What? I don't even know what that would be based on. I guess the difference in their color values? Maybe. I don't know, why not? Okay, so yeah, they oscillate based on the difference in their color values, so right. When should we check this? So, yeah, no, maybe I guess unfixed update, I guess.